Hello everyone and welcome to this section. In this section, we're going to cover the support vector machines, which is a very famous classification algorithm that we're going to be using to classify data points or data sets. And so the order of the mainly the section, we're going to start with the support vector machine intuition, and we're going to go ahead and cover two major projects that we're going to apply support vector machines from scratch, including, you know, importing the data set, cleaning up the data set, and actually applying the support vector machines in action. All right, so let's go ahead and cover the support vector machines intuition. Let's assume that you are a data scientist who is working at a major bank in New York City, all right? And as a data scientist, you are working with other bankers. And what the bankers do in general is that they sit with people or customers and they try to collect data about their age, okay, and about their savings, which is what we call it, let's say 401k savings, which is one of the savings plans in the United States, where people look at their retirements, try to save money for their retirements, where they can use it after they reach age of 60 years old, for example. So what you're looking for, that you wanted to classify a new clients as eligible to retire or not, given their customer features. So simply put, customers come, they provide you with their age, if they are, let's say, 30 years old, 40 years old, 50, 60, 70, or whatever, and they will provide you with the savings amount, which is their amount of dollars saved in their 401k retirement. So simply, we have two features. Here we have feature one, which is the age. Here we have feature two, which is the savings. And simply, we have two mainly kind of classes, okay? The first class, which is the red class that we have here, is that people who are not eligible to retire. And here we have our gray class, which is our people who are eligible to retire, all right? So what we're trying to do is, instead of asking or letting the banker decide on their own based on this, we're just gonna get all the data points, train a model that can simply, we're gonna provide it with the age, with the savings, and it can predict for us, you know, if that customer is eligible to retire or not, okay? All right, so the question is here, how can we separate these two classes? That's what we're looking for. So the first question is, okay, maybe this line would work great. Maybe this line would be able to classify or separate these two classes together, all right? Maybe somebody will say, okay, maybe not that line. Maybe this line would be able to separate these two classes from each other. Someone might say, no, maybe this might be able to classify these two classes or like separate them. And that's where the power of support vector machines comes into play. Support vector machines try to simply use what we call the support vectors, which is these two points in here. Okay, I'm gonna tell you exactly what they mean by support vectors, to try to find what we call the maximum margin hyperplane. Again, what support vector machines is trying to do as kind of an algorithm, it's trying to find that line in here, which is perfectly separate these two classes from each other. This line is what we call the maximum margin hyperplane, okay? And these two, are kind of this distance in here is what we call the maximum margin. And these two points is what we call the support vectors, all right? So what do you mean by this? In a nutshell, what support vector machine is doing is it's trying to find these two points on the boundary, which is like these two points are kind of hard to classify them as either retired or not. They are in the boundary in here. They might be even closer to each other. And what support vector machine is trying to do is trying to find what we call the maximum margin hyperplane, which is that green line that perfectly separates the two, so that the distance in here between these two, between the first class or the first support vector and that maximum margin hyperplane, and this distance in here, which is between the support vector of the other class and that maximum margin hyperplane, kind of will be equal and will be maximized in a way. So we're trying to maximize that distance in a way, kind of push that line away from here, push that line away from here, so we can perfectly separate the two classes from each other, all right? If you guys don't get that, I have kind of a more detailed example that can walk you through what do we mean by the support vectors. Let's assume that we wanted to, for example, classify images of animals to either cats or dogs, all right? So these class, all the gray points, these are the cats. Here, all these red points are the dogs, right? So if we take a look at it, you will find that here, these two features might be, let's say, for example, like the size of the nose, for instance, and maybe the size of the ears, okay? Think of these two features as something like that. So this point, okay, is what we call it the perfect cat. Because of the feature one and feature two, this point is really difficult to be classified as a dog, which is, you know, if you take a look at the picture here, it looks, you know, like looks exactly like a cat, you know, like nobody will ever say, okay, no, this is a dog. This is like kind of a perfect 100% cat, which is with a very high accuracy, okay, or a very high kind of, you know, like confidence. And that's why these points are really far in there. They are pure cats. These points, they are really far to the left-hand side, and they are pure dogs, okay? Their features are exactly a dog. Like looking at that picture, it looks like a perfect dog. However, in here, these two points are like something like this, you know? It's like, I found that a picture actually on the internet. It's kind of, you know, like, it's really difficult to tell. Is this a cat or is this like a dog, all right? And that's what we call it, the supported vectors. So what the supported vector machine's algorithms does for classification, it simply goes to these points on the boundary. They have kind of very mixed features. They are not pure gray, they are not pure red, they are something in between, all right? And they try to look for these two support vectors and try to find that hyperplane or the maximum margin hyperplane, which is perfectly separate these two features. And that's the power of supported vector machines. You will actually find that when we apply the supported vector machines in action, you will find that the actual classification results are great. Why? Because it only goes to the maximum or to the extremes and try to classify them based on these two support vectors. All right? Okay. I hope you guys were able to right now understand what do you mean by the support vectors, okay, and what do you mean by the maximum margin hyperplane. All right. So what happened is here is that we have, this is our trained model. It's what we call it, the maximum margin hyperplane in here. And in general, when we try to evaluate our model, we simply do two steps. We actually covered that before here. I'm just repeating it again. We use these points mainly for training. So we're actually gonna feed the algorithm, what we call it X-train and Y-train, including these two classes, all right? And what happened is after we train the model, which is after we obtain our maximum margin hyperplane in here, we are going to use different data points. And these green points are what we call it, the testing data set. We pass the testing data set in here to try to test our model afterwards, after we perform the training, okay? And that's pretty much the process we're gonna be following. We're gonna take all our points, divide them into two categories, training and testing. The key element is that training data sets, these are data points, which is our green data points here, that have never been used or seen during training. So which means when we train the model, when we try to obtain that straight line in here, we have to make sure that these data points were never being fed during training. They are completely new data points, never been seen by the algorithm, and that's how we can test the algorithm generalization capability, its ability to actually classify new data points that has never been seen before during training. All right, okay. That's pretty much all the intuition for the support vector machines. Obviously, there's a lot of mathematics. If you guys are interested, you guys can access these two books. The first book is what we call it Understanding Machine Learning from Theory to Algorithms. And the other book is what we call it an Introduction to Statistical Learnings in R. And these two books are free, so you guys can access them here. So I included the link for the first book. This is the link for the second book. And if you go to page 202 in the first book or page 337 in the second book, actually have them open in here, you guys can get more understanding of the support vector machines in way more details. So here, for example, the first book, this support vector machines, again, if you scroll down, that's page 338, you will find, you know, the definitions of what do you mean by a hyperplane, how can we find a hyperplane. Obviously, the hyperplane is the best line that can, you know, like classify these two points, the blue and red. And here it's showing you all the, how can we obtain that, all the mathematics behind it, which line would be perfect fit, and so on and so forth. Obviously, there's a lot more details in here. I'm not going to dig a little bit into the mathematics, tons of mathematics behind it. I'm just going to walk you through the intuition And then afterwards, we're going to take a look at the practical applications into how can we apply support vector machines in action. All right. If you go to the second book, which is Understanding Machine Learning, if you go down to page 202 and 203, you will find that there is an entire section for support vector machines going through all the details, how can we select the support vectors, and how to do all the mathematics behind it as well. Again, if you guys are interested, all that is purely optional. We don't need it actually to understand all the details behind it, because in this course, we're going to take a look at the support vector machines from a practical perspective. All right. Okay, let's recap what we have done so far. So in this section, we're able to cover the intuition for support vector machine, and the idea of how can we find the maximum margin hyperplane, which is the line that can perfectly separate these two classes. And to do that, we use the support vectors, which is, again, points or data points that are on the boundary. They are very difficult to kind of classify them purely as class A or class B, which is either retire or not retire in this case. And here we took a look as well at kind of an overview of this is a pure cat, this is a pure dog, this is kind of in between, you know, maybe cat, maybe dog. And these are the support vector in here. And these, again, you know, like images that have kind of mixed features. They are very difficult to classify. And that's why when we apply support vector machines, we use these two mainly points to find the maximum margin hyperplane, which is the perfect line that can separate completely the two classes from each other. All right. Okay. And we also take a look at how can we use the training and testing data sets into our model. And also here, if we have an additional reading material. I hope you guys enjoy this lecture and see you in the next lecture.